Well, I'm working on a few caps up on the board, and got the one in the back without fanfare. Clipped the old piece out, and I clipped the studs down and put the cap across it. Came up fine. I didn't have long enough leads on some of these other caps that they sent me, so I tacked one on across here. It went fine. Then I had the cap that was standing up here, and I said, oh, it's right at the edge of the board. Let me just take it out and put the other one right in. Well, now we got problems. As you can see, the trace is lifted. Even on this one, the trace started to lift a bit. So now, I'm going to have to figure out another way to do this. This trace here actually goes right over to this resistor here. It's already been replaced some time back. So I'm just going to, and then this trace actually is hooked to the ground, which is this right here. So even though it's kind of unconventional and something I normally wouldn't do in order to not get into any more trouble with this circuit board, I'm going to, oh, you can see the trail. I was looking from the bottom side to try to see where these traces went. Oh, well, actually, this goes to this side of the resistor. Okay. Well, I think the cap that went here, I'm going to put it across here and just bypass this. I've stepped down to the old 25-watt weller, so we'll see. We'll see how it turns out. Alright, so of course this isn't like I would prefer things to be. It's nice looking or whatever, but basically now instead of having the capacitor that went from ground here to the positive on this side, even though these were non-polarized, I tacked this from the resistor here to the lead, the extra lead I tacked onto this capacitor. It goes to the same ground, and you know, technically it'll work the same. I decided to put it here instead of bringing it all the way over here because I didn't want to reheat and re-disturb these traces, this trace down here that I had already heated to put this on one time. I mean, they really this thing come out. They're really delicate. And that 40-watt iron just lifted that right off of there, which, you know, normally, you know, I used a 25-watt iron for, you know, more modern stuff. Usually the solder they used back then, back in these times, a lot of times the 25, like, when I was taking the cans off the back of this thing, I just happened to have the 25-watt iron on the bench, and it didn't even get the solder melted. So we had a few more caps to do. I think I missed this one here. I'm going to leave it alone. But we've got the safety cap just hiding back there. That won't be a problem. And we got these two. This came on. We got this cap right here. But I've got really, you know, I'm starting to have second thoughts unless I really have to do it. I might just leave this alone because there's no good way to get down there. And there's no good way to get to the back of it. Alright, well, we got the new safety cap in, which was important. And oh, goodness, let's see. I'll tell you what, I gotta go back to the eye doctor, folks. I haven't had my glasses updated in 5 or 6 years, and well, I'm not even wearing them right now because it's just really, you know, not making anything any better. Oh, look at this. Well, what do we have back here? I don't know if y'all see what I see. I see some resistors. Okay. So I see some resistors broken in half, but that's what these are tacked across here for. Alright. Hmm. That was done deliberately by a prior serviceman. Okay, well that works. He probably didn't want to screw with traces either. The traces lifting off. What grand fun that is. Well, I guess the next, I'm not going to bother with the other paper caps for now. I know it's a paper cap there, but, oh goodness. I'm going to put it again, since I can get to this one. And one thing that kind of disappointed me is that I missed when I went to order all the caps. This is a paper cap back here. And I missed that one when I was looking through everything. And that is a 0.018 at 600 volts. So C42 is part of the... Yeah, I better change that. And it's all on this high. This horizontal output circuit. Now here's the flyback. Let's see, C42. It's like a bypass to ground. No, the 255 volt source. So it's not the boost cap. We've changed that. In fact, the reason I want to change this is that this is actually the cap that was the section of the can that was bad, that was smoking. It was actually, you know, this one right here, making this boost. So I'm gonna dig around and see what I have for this. But really, this is a bear. I have to pull everything back apart, and it's the only thing left back here you can't get to with the CRT in place. So we're gonna do our darndest to find something to put back there. Only see this is like Philco. A barrier resistor back here. Now I'm gonna test it since I missed it before. Yeah, can you believe that? That's where it's buried. All this wiring. Speechless. Well, not really, but you know. Alright, so I dug around and 0.018, I hit a 0.02, which was just right in the tolerance limit, but we're going to put that in there. It was even the correct voltage, so I probably have a special order to 018. And we're going to put this thing back together and see what happens. I tested these resistors, and they all tested a little high. I mean, they all tested a little high, right on or right outside, you know, the percentage. But, you know, I have to undo so much crap back here. I'm going to see how the TV performs first. I'm going to see how the TV performs and check some voltages. And if I have to pull it back apart, so be it. But sometimes it's better to let sleeping dogs lie. You know, a lot of this stuff with these tube sets wasn't absolutely critical. Alrighty, and the vertical output tube was shorted, so I dug around and I found a new one. Radtel radio television, guaranteed. Who was this made by? No telling. Let me see. Radtel Tube Company, made in USA. Yeah, heck. Let's see, we'll insert it. See where it goes. Alright, so we got all the tubes in place. Let's fire her up. Alrighty, got filaments.
30. Well, you see, it's compressed at the top. If you make the picture roll, see, it's not the... See, when you get the top of the picture in the lower part of the screen, it's sized normally. When it gets to the top, it's compressed. I've tried making some adjustments and...
These are the real life-saving things your 50 cents a day will buy. It's simple, affordable, and it could mean the difference between life and death. All it takes is 50 cents a day and a minute of your
time. Did a noise change with the contrast control?
Please, do it right now.
So there you go. That's where we're at.